What's going on, guys? It's Waffle here. Welcome back to some more Blightfall. And as you can see, the Totem of Dawn has cleaned up a significant amount of area here. I don't know how many ethereal blooms and how long it'd take to actually, you know, detaintify this area on their own, but with this Totem of Dawn, I've just been over there filling up different jars and stuff with different essentia to make more of these bad boys, and this thing's already pretty much cleaned up this whole entire area. I guess I'll just help it out a little bit by getting rid of that little bit of fibrous taint, get a little bit of that fibrous taint right there. The one downside of this thing is, like I said earlier, or like I said last episode, is that, like, It detaintifies in patterns and different, like, spots, random spots. It doesn't, like, go in a line back and forth, kind of like what I do with the ethereal blooms. So, that's one downside to it, I suppose. But, Lelis was detaintifying the area really, really, really well, and I'm really proud of this thing. It looks fantastic. I need to, you know, bring forward a few of these ethereal blooms and get rid of this little strip of taint right there, so suppose I might as well do that right about now, but looks like these ethereal blooms are kind of obsolete. If anything, the only thing they'd be used for is just, you know, cleaning up after in a mess like this. So I guess I'll just put a few ethereal blooms right there and get rid of this huge little farm of ethereal blooms over here I used to get for the to clean out that little cave system underground. So I think we're good to go with that. So look at this. Everything looks fantastic. I can't wait to go. I guess we could go to the what's it called? The Jaded. I almost forgot the name of the ship. But we can go aboard the Jaded here in a bit. Maybe after we make a few more of these Totem of Dawns and see what they think about the whole area being detaintified and whatnot. I think it's a pretty good amount of area already detaintified. So I suppose what we could do is maybe put one or two of these things on, like, the swamp area. Yeah, it looks like this. Yeah, the swamp will probably need 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe even 5 and 6 to get this little thing right there, you know, to clean out the area. But to clean the swamp, it might need only like 4 or 5 of those bad boys. So it's going to be really, really, really easy to clean that out. And speaking of really easy to clean stuff out, look at this. Pretty much just surrounding the taint with ethereal blooms. This thing is gone in an instant. Just wait a little while. Man. All right, there you go. I should probably get a few of these, actually. Put them over here by this bit. There we go. There we go. Get rid of that. Oh man, I broke the grass block right there. Whoops. I wanted to get rid of the fibrous taint. There you go. Anyways, as I was saying, I was filling up the jars of essentia, or like the warded jars, I guess you can call them. Oh, here's another ethereal bloom we just grab and place over there. I was filling those up, and then I got a comment from someone saying that I should put, like, candles and stuff around the... Where should we put this one? Oh, wow, this is, like, almost completely cleaned up already. Jeez. But we should put candles around the, what's it called? The infusion altar or something like that? That we should put them over there. That'll reduce the instability of it and make it a little bit more stable. So, that is something I'm definitely interested in. If you guys remember last episode, I think it had, like, one explosion or something, and something fell off, or maybe one of the ethereal blooms got zapped or something. Oh, wow. Ignore that death point right there. I got killed by a furious zombie in the middle of the night. But, yeah, look at this. Our jars are completely filled up. Everything's up to 64. Oh, God, Sano's not 64. I have to go fill it up a little bit. Let's go see if I have any Sano over here. 62, though, is pretty close. Yeah, there's two right there. Perfect. All right, well, let's see. Everything should be at 64 because I do have extra jars of this stuff, the Aurum, and extra jars of Ordo. And this Tudeman stuff, whew, I thought it'd be really hard, but all I did was just breed the cows, and multiply them, and then kill their parents, and get a bunch of leather. And then I just grabbed a bunch of the extra armor and stuff that I wasn't really using, and just threw that inside the whatever was it called? Alchemical furnace? I just threw those inside the alchemical furnace. Got a bunch of Tudeman, as well as, like, Metallum and other trash I don't really need. And yeah, that's how I filled that one up. And I think all we have to do now is just make those little bits that go on the pedestals themselves, like the Order Crystal Cluster. We're going to need some of those. So let's get our backpack out and Order Shard. There you go. So we're going to need 6 of these things. I can only make 6 of these out of the amount I have right now. So there we go. There's 6 of those Order Shards. Let's get 5. Let's get 5 in case we need these Order Shards for something here in the future. Let's just keep those. And then what else are we going to need? We're going to need those 2 ethereal blooms we already have. We have the silverwood logs. We have the paving stone. Ooh. We only have 1 paving stone awarding right now, though. So maybe, how do you get these paving stones? I think, where was it? Somewhere. Maybe it was Thaumaturgy. Maybe it was in the basic information bit. Or maybe artifice? Oh, yep, yep, here it is right here. Paving stone of warding. Keep things out. I don't have to require it. Oh, I need a little bit more of that modus stuff. Got, let's see, how much modus do we have? Oh, we have no modus. Okay, well, that's easy. Just air and ordo, get a few of those. There you go. Let's see if we can unlock that and get that research done. There you go. Paving stone of travel. Oh, might need that here in the future. I don't know. What does that do? Is that like a teleporter thing? It might be. Either that or it, like, instead of warding stuff away, it'll, like, bring it stuff towards it, maybe? I don't know. Let's see how difficult this research is. Where is it? Did I unlock it? Oh, wait. Is it even a... Oh, I can just go right into it. Okay, well, it looks like arcane stone bricks with order shards. That is really... Oh, wait. Oh, I'm glad I kept these the order shards, because we need order shard, and then we need fire shard, and then we're also going to need Ignis and Ordo from our wands, so I'm glad I kept those order shards instead of converting them all into a order cluster thing. Maybe you might be able to turn those clusters back into... No, you can't. Huh. It's not that big of a deal, I suppose. Our wand is almost completely filled up. You know what? Let's use this opportunity to go over to our wand recharge station and see if this thing can fill it up all the way up to 100%. Yeah, there you go. Sucking up that, Perdicio? Yep, there you go. And sucking up the Ignis all the way up to 100, 100, 100, 100, 100, and 100. Perfect. Full wand right here. And I think I accidentally got the scepter, like last episode. So yeah, crafting scepters. So I don't know how much better scepters are than wands. Maybe they hold like 200 or maybe 150 capacitor or something like that. But we're not really running into any problems with the capacity. So maybe we'll get it. Maybe we won't. I don't think it's that big of a deal right now. Either way, I think we need to get some of those arcane stone brick. There you go. Perfect. And we might have to go downstairs and get a little bit of stone. Let's see how much stone. Oh, Stobney. Stop talking Stobney. Let's see. Arcane stone. Do we have any arcane stone bricks already in here? Blank slate. Oh, there's a little bit of stone right there. A little bit of Stobney. But that's only 6. I think we're going to need at least 8 to be able to make more of those arcane things. There's one piece of glass. Let's just get some, regular anythings. Yeah, basalt, cobblestone. Throw that inside of there. I did get some comments saying I should throw sand into the smeltery to get double the sand, but whenever you throw sand into a smeltery, that gets you that clear glass stuff, not the actual, like, Minecraft glass, so I'm pretty sure if I did that, I wouldn't be able to do the crafting recipe for some of these things that I need to do. Either way, here's a little bit of basalt. We should be able to make a little bit more of those paving stones or whatever right now, but I'm going to wait until I have at least 2 crafts of these bad boys, and I think for that, I'm going to need 10 basalt, so... we're almost there. That's pretty good. And then, of course, we will need those ethereal blooms, which I guess, yeah. Yes, yeah, we're not going to really need all those ethereal blooms anymore. We're going to use them to craft some of those. Oh my god. Whoa. What? Strange whispers reveal secrets to you. That was spooky. Did that say anything? All I did was hear, like, a heartbeat. What was that? What in the world? Did Satan himself just whisper something in my ear? I don't know. Either way, let's go over here. Let's go to our backpack. Let's grab like a shard, air shard, blah. I don't care what shard we use. So let's just use any shard and surround it with stoneroo like you. And then there you go. A little bit of that. And there you go. Oh, there you go. And get another craft. There you go. Perfect. And how do you make the thing like that? Yep, there you go. Perfect. And we're going to need them to be arcane stone bricks, right? Let's check. Let's double check. Yep. Arcane stone brick. Perfect. Let's get some of those. And yeah, there's 8 right there. Yeah, I guess I'll keep these. I'll keep these extra arcane things just in case I need them in the future. Either way, we're going to need the Ignis ones. Fire shard. We're going to need those fire shards. And we're going to need this wand to go up here because it has Ignis and whatnot inside of it. So there's that. There's the order. And there's the stone bricks. So there's paving stones of warding. Perfect. Perfect. There's 8 of those bad boys. And we need 2 of them for one thing of dawn, so we're able to make 4 out of the amount of paving stones we have right now. So 4, and then 5 of the order crystals. So, you know what? Yeah, let's get 5. Because if we make 5 more of those totems of dawn, we'll have 6 in total, which is an absolutely insane amount. Jeez. So definitely looking forward to that. So let's get 2 more of those, and then craft that. And then we need to do that, and put fire at the top. Order on the bottom, and there you go, 4 more paving stones. Actually, yeah, you get 4 per craft, so that means we're able to get 6 of those now. All right, well, that's good. Anyways, we have enough ethereal blooms to cover all that stuff. Isn't there one more thing that we might need? Oh, that's the wrong thing. Alchemy, is that it? Yep, here it is right here. No, I guess that's it. I think we've got it. Huh. All right, well, I guess now all we have to do now is work on the instability of the whole thing. And I guess I'll put the paving stones, the order shards, and all the extra shards. I'll put those all up in there just so I know where they're at and put all that trash up. Now, I do remember... Remember when we went to that mountain over there and we found the, what was it, like the light gray, yeah, I think it was the light gray flowers. God, monsters near, what is it? Is it that creeper? Is there something? Oh, there's a creeper right there. There is a creeper. Oh, man, that was so close. Whew, if you would have exploded right there, you would have killed that doggy. Oh, man. Anyways, let's go to bed. Jeez. There we go. Anyways, let's go to, no. We don't need to go anywhere. God, there's so many creepers. How? There's so many creepers. 2 creepers there, 1 creeper there, a cow there. Wishes he was a creeper, though, I bet. Anyways, let's head over to that mountain over there. I hope I have enough food. Our lunch boxes are... They look like they have stuff inside of them, but I don't know how much stuff is inside of them right now. But let's head over there to that mountain, because I remember there were candles over there, and there might be more candles on the tainted city over there, the floating city. Oh yeah, I got a lot of comments from you guys saying that reminding me that I said once I get a totem of dawn that I go detaintify the city. So once we make a few more of these totems of dawn, then I'll definitely go set a few of them over there at the floating city, start detaintifying it and stuff like that. But yeah, let's see, where is this? I think it was on the other side of the river. It might have been on the other side of the river. I have a feeling it might have. Where's that? Was that entrance like right here? I don't remember. I felt like there was an entrance like on the river. Or, oh, here it is, right? Oh, yeah, it's close, though. Let's see, how many candles does he have? These are colored candles, though. Come into purple tallow cat. I think that might be it. Let's see, let's just grab those. There you go, and we're supposed to put them on the top. Fancy redstone brick panel. Okay, yeah, we don't really need that. And I think there used to be heads there, and I think I grabbed them. So I got a comment saying that, candles and heads are able to, help the stability of our arcane infusion altar is the technical term for it, but that's going to help it out in that front. So anyways, I'm going to make my way back home and I'll see you guys here in a bit. All right, guys, we are pretty much here. Let's see. I wanted to check, out of range? How am I out of range? There we go. Jeez, head. How many heads? Okay, so we have 2 zombie heads. We have another head over here. Yeah, 1 zombie head there. There might have been more heads at the floating city. I think there might have been. Yeah, let's go to there. Floating city. Let's go back to the floating city. I don't know where these heads would... all I remember is that in the potion shop, you guys remember, I think there might have been candles, and I think there might have been skulls. Either that or I might have grabbed the skull. I think I might have grabbed the skull, so there might be candles still left over there. So let's just go back and check anyways. Because if there are any, whew, that'll save us a little bit of time and money on our car insurance. But let's just go back inside the shop and let's see. I missed a night ore thing here. Huh. Didn't think I went. Oh, there's 2 of them. There you go. Grab both of those. Don't mind if I do. Eat a little bit more of this juicy food. Is there anything I might have missed here? Any more night ore? Just regular torches and a bunch of potions I don't really need right now. All right. Well, nothing. What is that? Deep iron ore. I don't think I need that right now. Oh, yep, here's 1 candle. Light gray tallow candle thing. It's really dark right now, so I can barely see, but I guess I'll take that cauldron. If anything, I get a little bit of iron from that, and I think there might have been... No, that's not it. Oh, I guess I grabbed it whenever I came back. Huh. All right, well, there's 1 more candle there. All right, we're getting a pretty good amount of these candles, though. Kind of surprised that there's this many candles just kind of hidden all over the place. I wonder if they're in, like, every building. There might be. Nothing inside of here, I believe. Oh, just a bunch of seeds and trash. Not picking up anything else right now. Where else would anything be? Thinking here. Oh, I think I got a comment back whenever we came over here to get those blue. Oh, yeah, I already got them. I must have gotten them off camera. But someone got really upset that I left those light blue flowers behind. So I guess I already grabbed them, so that's good. Anyways, let's try and let's go to the redstone shop. Let's see if there's anything inside there. Like any candles, any stuff? Oh, whoops, that's not it. Any candles back here? No. God, I'm getting tainted all over the place. God, what is down here? Just a bunch of those bamboo sticks. Yeah, just oh whoa, the skull. There's a skull there. Oh man, I forgot that I was looking for skulls too. There's 1 skull. Oh, 2 skulls. Perfect. What's that thing? Oh, order infused stone. So that's going to give us an order shard, right? Get rid of this punji stick. Punji stick. Break it, break it, break it, break it. Oh my god. Whew, there you go. Oh, am I dead? Okay, I'm not dead. Oh, I had to break it with an axe. Let's break those with an axe then. Jeez. Oh man, we were on like one heart right there. Could have died. Didn't die. Thankfully. Jeez, thanks, Notch. Anyways, let's get those order shards right there. Because we're definitely going to need them. Especially to make more of those order crystal things if we ever want to make more than like six of those. Kind of scared I might get tainted. Six of those. Oh, there's even more right there. Ooh. Ooh, even more. Good stuff. Huh. I haven't gotten money in a long, 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 long time. So, oh, whoa. I think maybe if the skull falls on this punji stick or punji stick, pungi. Punji stick? I don't know how to pronounce it, but I think it might, I think it might be like a cactus where it like destroys items, so kind of afraid that might happen. So let's grab that skull. There you go. Let's grab that skull, and we'll have two more skulls, so we'll have five skulls, I think. Okay, let's just jump over this punji stick. Oh, there we go. Ooh, man. Whew. Let's get the cobblestone. Let's get out of here. There we go. Oh, got taint. Get out of here. Well, we have a pretty good amount of skulls. I think we have a pretty good amount of candles. Is there a candle? Oh, another two candles, I think. And what's that fancy gold brick? Ooh, that's basically a gold block. A gold block. What just came out of my mouth right there? A gold block. Well, let's just grab that candle. Let's grab that. It makes a weird, like, wool sound whenever you break that candle, you know? It sounds like I'm breaking wool. Anything in there? Traveler's goggles. I think I already talked about that. Let's see. Let's check these houses real quick. We're back up to full health, so we can get tainted all we want. But, nothing. Fancy lamp. I don't think I need that. It does look pretty cool, though. Not gonna joke. There's that trash can thing. Ooh. That might come in handy for you in the future, but, I'll take the tunics and stuff. I'll take those, because I can get, mossy stone brick, cobblestone, because I can get, tutamen from those things, so that's good. And what's that thing? Is that an actual? Oh, that's a fancy workbench. That is a pretty fancy workbench. Not going to joke. All right, well, since he. Oh, is that another fan? Oh, that's glowstone. What are you? Oh, villager, get out of here, villager trash. Villager trash. Tainted villager trash. Get out of here. Whew, let's go. What's the. Oh, whoa, what is this? Milk bottles and stuff? Oh, potion of water breathing. Cactus juice. And a cloud in a bottle. Whoa, what the? Cloud in a bottle. We have a backpack, might as well use it, so let's put the night ore up there, order shards, yeah, order shards belong up there anyways, let's put that up there, blah blah blah, yeah, let's just put anything up there, I'll organize it later, there's a little bit of potion of water breathing, cloud in a bottle, milk bottle, cactus juice, and just water bottles there, but look at this, is all the stuff that you can get from milk bottles, really good, two Sano, two of those fames things, one aqua, one Victus, and one of those glass things, not bad, so let's see. Is there any, I don't know if I want to risk it. Let's just head back. Let's just head back. I picked up a little bit of tank goo. I don't want that trash. So let's get out of here. And, I guess we can just try and head back home. And, oh, taking a shortcut. Oh, there might be, I think there might be something in this building, right? Nothing. Is this a bookshelf? Oh, yeah, it's a bookcase. God, that was one of those shelf things that I could use to, oh, whoa. Man, this is a map of the thing. Huh. Oh, my. I didn't know that. That's what it looks like before it was tainted. That's interesting. All right, well, we're getting really low on health right now, so let's just head back to the teleporter thing. Head back to Biome Alpha before we die. There you go. Whew. And I guess we can start trying to destabilize our infusion altar over there, so let's go do that real quick. And I think I read that you can add... God, let's just get rid of that embarrassing thing. Get rid of that death point. There you go. I think you can put them under the thing instead of just inside the thing, so it can kind of declutter it a little bit, so let's just put it under it. And I don't know how many blocks under we can go, so let's just do this. Let's just place them all under, and I think they have to be, like, symmetrical or something. So if we place, okay, there's the edge of that. So if we place something here, we have to put another thing here. And I don't think it really matters like how symmetrical it is. I think that as long as there's like an item in the symmetrical area, so like we can put a candle on one end and a skull on the other end, I think. So, oh, that's dirt, right? Yep, that's grass, I guess. But I think that's how it works. I think that's not bad. I should probably get the excavator to kind of break this gray. It's probably like pitch black for you guys right now. There's a grass block and here's arcane stone. Okay, there you go. All right. I don't think I really need the excavator for that. I guess I could. Yeah, let's get the excavator out. Do I have that in my backpack? Yep, there it is right there. Don't mind if I do, gonna get rid of all this grass. Easy peasy, no, but look at that, that's so handy. God, I love tools like this. So handy. There you go. And we can just put these candles and stuff under the thing, and it'll still, I think, affect the stability of the arcane infusion altar. There's our excavator. Actually, we need to put that in our backpack. There you go. Speaking of backpack, let's grab all of our candles. Here's the purple candles, light gray. Any more candles? Well, here's the skull. That was a zombie. Yeah, here's the skeleton skull, so there's that. So we can just kind of put them anywhere, I guess. So let's just put this on the corners. There's purple. Perfect. Perfect. There's another thing right there, and I guess we can just kind of place them like in an X pattern, I suppose. Do we have enough? I guess we don't. All right, so I think because we don't have enough candles, then we can just kind of get rid of those. But we can start putting like skulls down here too. So let's just put a skull there. And let's put a skeleton skull there, and then a zombie skull here. The skeleton skull there. Ooh, spooky. But let's see. Is there anything else that might help stabilize the thing? Oh, yeah, we actually have enough candles. Huh. Yeah, I forgot we had a yellow candle there. All right, so there's that. There's that. All right, so this is how we're going to be stabilizing it right now. And I think you're actually able to make those candles. You have to look in my recipe book here in a second, or my thought when I've gone. Well, let's see. Where would that be for the thing? For the candles? Is it this? Magic tallow? Oh, yeah, that's the thing. Magic tallow. And it's just rotten flesh with some precantatio. That's cheap. That's really cheap. And we have a lot of rotten flesh on us right now, right? Yeah, I killed a lot of zombies, so let's just go upstairs. And, well, you can... Yeah, you just walk over these candles. That's kind of cool. They don't, like, block your path or anything. Anyways, dirt. Let's get out of here. There you go. All right, so hopefully it's going to stabilize it at least a little bit. And then what was I going to? Oh yeah, rotten flesh with precantatio. So let's go grab some precantatio shards out of our little shard chest over here. It should be purple. Yep. Vidium. Do I have any pro? Oh, I have a little bit of precantatio. I think I might have some precantatio here. No, here. Yeah, I have. Okay, 24 there. So let's just do this. Let's just put this there. Open up the valve. There you go. And yep, there you go. They're being turned into shards. Perfect. All right. So I guess I kind of want to go to bed real quick. I don't want to get touched by spooky zombies at night all the time. It seems like it's always nighttime outside. So I'm just going to go to bed real quick, and I'll see you guys here in the morning. There you go. Morning time. Delicious morning time. What were we going to do? Oh, yeah, we're going to make more of those, make some of those, what are they called? Those candle things? I forgot what those were called, like the technical term for them. But let's see. What was I going to get? Oh, yeah, we need a bucket. Fill up with some water so we can fill up our cauldron. There you go. And fill up the cauldron, and then just throw the precantatio in there. And we're going to need two parts per rotten flesh. So two precantatio, and then one rotten flesh. It's going to get us one of those things. I completely forgot what they're called. But let's just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then one. Oh, wait, there's one right there. And there you go. 10, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There we go. Perfect. I think you need... Let's check. Two to craft the candle. Oh, that gets you three candles. Oh, that's good. Okay, so two of the, yeah, you need two, so we can't just make them right now. Let's just do one more. One, two, and then rotten flesh. There you go, perfect. All right, so we have enough to make, how many do we have? Ooh, we have enough to make 3 times 3. We have enough for 9, so, 9 of those candles. That might, yeah, I think that's enough. And we have string right there. Let's see if we have any more string. Yep, we have some string there. Perfect. Let's see, should we, let's just, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, there we go, and let's just go grab some of those precantatio shards that are making, that we did before we went to bed. Let's see if we can go, make a few more of those things. Let's see, how many do we have? Two of them there, and two of them there. Perfect. All right, so we can make, we can make 3 more of these crafts. Not bad. Alright, so I'm having a little bit of fun with all this Thaumcraft stuff, if you guys haven't noticed. I remember like 20 episodes ago, maybe, I was like really just like, I don't know what to do. Then I finally just jumped in with both feet for the Thaumcraft stuff, and now I'm just having a blast with all this stuff. Let's get our wand. Any wand will work, and just empty that out. Make sure there's no taint clouds there, you know. Anyways, what were we going to do? Oh yeah, we need to go over here to, I think you have to use the, the magic table thing. What's it called again? Arcane work table. Let's use that. Then get the string and then the magic tallow stuff. There we go. Perfect. And how do you get the different colors? Do you have to like get a dye and then put it next to it or what usages for that? Yeah. And you can just do that in a regular crafting table too. Huh. All right. Well, let's go over here where we have flowers. Let's see. What kind of dyes do we have? We have red there. I don't think we have a red candle, so let's get some red. Those are mystical orange, so I don't know if I want to use those mystical flowers, you know. Tall mystical flower. Yeah, I don't know if I have anything else here. Let's see, do we have any, like, dandelions or anything around here? I might have to get a little bit of a... Oh, what just died right here? Did I not pick up an XP? I don't know. Either way, red's good. Yeah, let's just get red. So let's get the rose musharoo. Let's do a little bit of that. And where do the candles go? I think we might have left it in the crafting table, right? Yep, there it is right there. Let's get a few of those red candles. There you go. Two of those. Not bad. And the rest of them can just be white. Eh, doesn't matter. So, oh man, I am hungry again. Are you kidding me? All right, well, let's at least fill up that whole entire downstairs area. And then we can try and make a few more of those totems of Dawn. And see exactly if it's going to like help the stability and whatnot. So, there we go. I guess we can put the red like that. There you go. And just kind of put white on the or let's put white on the border. Do we have a, oh, we might have maybe. Ooh, yeah, we don't have enough just yet to make it completely symmetrical, so there's that. And yeah, we don't have enough. I don't know. Yeah, let's get rid of these two. Just wait until we have enough candles, but this is what it looks like right now. Not bad at all. All right, so kind of proud of this. Looks pretty good. Not bad. So I suppose we can go upstairs and go make a Totem of Dawn real quick and see exactly if it made like any effect on how stable this stuff is. So let's go grab our ethereal blooms. Go grab the shard. Oh wait, we already have the, yeah, we already have the shards in our backpack. And the what is it called? The paving stone warding. Yeah, we have those as well. Just need to get some silverwood logs and the ethereal blooms. Perfect. So we can make two crafts right now with the ethereal blooms we have. And let's get our Phenomenon out real quick, just so we can see where exactly we need to put the, there it is right there. The ethereal blooms and stuff, so, yeah, I think we've got it. Yeah, okay. Alright, well, let's get the, other stuff out of here, order crystals. There we go, and the paving stuff, there we go. Paving stone of warding, let's get those over here on that back bit. Let's put the thing there. I think this needs to go there, and I think this needs to go here, and this needs to go here. So I think we've got it. Okay. All right. Well, let's go test it out. Let's go get our wand. There you go. Pretty sure that like any wand will work, but let's see. Is this going to work? So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Pretty sure there's 6 things in the Thaumonomicon that we need. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. We have it. Let's do it. Let's make another thing, whatever it's called. Let's see if that thing is even gonna help out with the stability and whatnot. God, it already fell off. Already zapped one of those ethereal blooms off. All right, well, I think we're good to go right now. Nothing else has been. God, I got zapped right there. It literally zapped me. I didn't even see that. Jeez. Anyways, let's get the crystals just in case that falls off. Paving stone's already in our hot bar in case that falls off. I think we're good right now. It might have. I don't know if it's helping the stability, because like right off the bat it just knocked off an ethereal bloom as you guys saw. But oh, one of the paving stones got knocked off. There you go. Need to keep my eyes peeled for that. Yeah, I got zapped again. okay, well, paving stones look good. Order shard thing looks good. Ethereal blooms look good. Still sucking out the essence from those jars. Come on. Still nothing. Sucking out the Lux now, okay. Paving stones look good. Order shard looks good. Ethereal blooms look good. Now it's sucking out the Tudeman, because I can see it's like blue. I think we're still good. Ethereal blooms are still standing. Oh, did it just suck that? No, it zapped it off. Let's put that on. There we go. God, don't zap me. okay. Paving stones back there, still good. Ethereal blooms still good. Order shard's been replaced. Come on, it's sucking out like Ordo right now. Is he gonna zap me? Oh, yep. It's almost done sucking out all the primal aspects and whatnot that it needs. And then soon it's gonna start sucking out the actual items. Come on. Suck out all that Ordo, hurry up. This is taking a lot longer than I remember last time, you know? But, there you go, Ethereal Bloom. That's gonna suck out the Order Shard. Or the Paving Stones, of course it doesn't do what I say. And then the Order Shard, come on, I hope I did it right. There it is, oh, we did it. I don't know if it was any more stable than before, you know? Even though last time it was a complete mess, I completely forgot about Ordo and stuff. But I think, I don't know, I'm pretty confident about making these Totems of Dawn. Man, I can't remember what they're called. But yeah, I feel really, really confident about it. So I don't know, where should we put this help? Yeah, let's actually check the, how much this can clean. So let's see, where's the center of this thing at? 1, 2, 3, 1, 22, 23, 24, about 24, 25-ish. That's really good. 25 in each direction, about 50 block diameter. That is awesome. That is so good. All right, well, with that in mind, let's go place this one about 50 blocks, or 25 blocks that way. So 1, 2, 3, 24, and 25. All right, so let's place this here. There we go. Whew. And it's going to clean out this area all the way out to there, hopefully. So I think we're going to be good to go. Look at that, it's already getting rid of that taint. Awesome. Okay, well, I think what I'm going to do now is maybe make a few more of those candles over there, you know, try and stabilize the thing as much as possible, at least. And I don't even know if what we placed down there even, like, made a dent in how stable it is. Maybe it did, maybe it didn't, I don't know. But I didn't really personally notice anything different. But I think what I'm going to do, make more of those candles, stabilize the thing, maybe make like 5-6 more of those Totems of Dawn, and then hopefully next episode we're going to have a really nice clean area, at least maybe all the way down to probably down to this tree line right here. Maybe I'm getting really confident about this, but maybe we're going to be able to clean all the way down there, and maybe I'll even get started cleaning the Mushroom Island and of course the Floating City. Definitely want to do that because you guys seem to really want me to do the Floating City, so I'll definitely do that. Don't worry about that. Anyways, I think that was a pretty good productive episode. We definitely stabilized our thing over there, probably, I don't know. But thank you guys all very much for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to let me know by leaving a like down below, and if you guys want more of these awesome videos, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'll put my latest videos on our YouTube homepage as soon as they come out so you don't miss an episode. But until then, thank you guys all very much for watching. And I'll see you guys here next time with some more Blightfall. Oh, bye there. God, my phone has just been going off like crazy.